Could you live without AR glasses?
Yes, you're probably also already doing it. And there is absolutely no reason to get an augmented reality headset, except for this one reason that we'll discuss in this video. If you have seen the latest news about augmented reality headsets, it's quite disappointing. The HoloLens 3 is probably not coming, and Apple also postponed its augmented reality headset indefinitely, so we have no clue when or if it will ever arrive. And that is because these companies are struggling with one particular component of an AR headset. And because these companies cannot get this one particular part right, soldiers get dizzy and they are less accurate in the battlefield. And apparently it's not up to the standard that Apple wants to have. And this component I'm talking about is an optical see-through display. And there's really one reason why you would want to have an AR headset with this particular display. But before I tell you, also subscribe to this channel to not miss any future uploads. Using this piece of technology, you can actually see the usual world around you as if you're looking through normal glasses. But anywhere where an augmented reality asset should be displayed, pixels turn on and you see the actual image in your surroundings. Plus, when you're just walking down the street, you don't look like a complete weirdo, because these future AR glasses should look like regular glasses. So, but then again, that's where the technology is going to, but we're definitely not there today. There are also augmented reality headsets on the market that don't utilize these optical see-through displays, such as the MetaQuest Pro, the Pico, and the Vive. With these devices, you can also see AR content in your physical space, but you will see it on a screen. So the camera feed is combined with the AR elements and then shown via a regular screen. And these types of hardware are much more developed than these optical see-through displays. You also see that people really like the MetaQuest Pro because you can use it for both virtual reality experiences and augmented reality experience. And then next to these AR headsets, we of course also have augmented reality on our mobile phones that we can utilize. For example, using your mobile phone in the winter app, you can actually go on an augmented reality tour in a city and see history come to life. So with all these different devices to experience AR, why or when should you want to use an AR headset? And when should you want to use an AR headset with an optical see-through display? Well, to answer the first question, when should you use an AR headset compared maybe to a mobile phone? I have four different things to consider. First of all, you should use an AR headset if a hands-free experience is important. Of course, you can utilize AR on a tablet or a mobile phone, but if you work at a factory, for example, and you want AR to be able to help your factory workers be more efficient, it's not very efficient if you can only use one hand and have to hold the iPhone with the other. The second thing to consider is if you want to use a spatial controller. So if you have AR on your phone, of course you only have the touchscreen that you can use. Some AR headsets offer also an actual controller that you can use for more precise interactions. Thirdly, I would say you should use an AR headset if you have an AR experience that lasts for more than 2 minutes without any breaks. If you have an AR experience and you have to hold your phone like this for more than 2 minutes, it can be quite exhausting for your arms. The fourth reason why you might want to use an AR headset is if you think it can improve safety. Because we all know that looking at your phone can be super distracting and you don't see everything around you. So these are just four things to consider, and there are probably many more, but they are very dependent on the use case, on your target audience, on the hardware. With these four things, I think you can already consider if it's wise to utilize an AR headset or not. Then the last question, when should you use an AR headset with an optical see-through display? These devices only make sense if you have an AR experience that people should do for a while without breaks. Let me show you this infographic right here. So on one hand, we have augmented reality on the phone. Then 2 minutes up until 30 minutes to an hour
it's wise to utilize these hybrid devices, these VR headsets that can do both VR and AR, because they are really great. They have a nice field of view. But the reason why I should limit this between the 2 minutes and maybe maximum of 30 minutes is because you're looking at the display the entire time. And that can be quite exhausting if you do that for a longer while. If you're an experienced VR gamer, then maybe up to an hour. And then on the other hand, if you work in a factory, for example, or if you're a student and you have to do an AR experience for more than half an hour, I would advise to use these optical see-through displays, because you're not constantly looking at a screen. You're also looking at the actual surroundings around you, and it's not that exhausting to your eyes. So my advice, before you really start using these kinds of headsets, try them for yourself and decide if it's good enough for your actual use case. If you really love this kinds of content, then subscribe to our channel, of course, because that really helps us. And I would like to invite you to try Winter. It's an AR tour editor that you can use on your mobile phone for location-based experiences.